Bam, Mr. Tarrou. In this video, we're going to take a look at the factorial symbol, or factorial notation. If n is a positive integer, the notation n factorial, or I like to say n, is the product of all positive integers from n down through 1. The definition, as it looks, is n equals n times n minus 1, you know, n factorial. N factorial is equal to n times n minus 1 times n minus 2. And what you're looking at in this part of the definition, it's simply saying that we can start with any positive integer. I don't know what it is, though. But I'm going to start counting back by 1. And then I'm going to subtract by 1 again and just continue to count back by 1 until I get to where I know I'm going to finish, which is 3, 2, and 1. 0 factorial, by definition, is equal to 1. It is by definition, so don't expect some kind of great proof as to, for me anyway, as to how 0 factorial becomes 1. But by definition, for the factorial symbol, 0 factorial does indeed equal 1. So we know that 0 factorial is equal to 1, you know, by definition. And also, though, just as a simpler example before I get to this one here in yellow, if I were to write, let's say, 4 factorial, or 4! How you calculate that, by this definition, you have some value raised to, you know, some value factorial. You start at that value, you count back by 1 until you get to 1. So 4 factorial would be equal to 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And you just, again, count backwards to get to 1. And when you're done, find the product of all those numbers. So 4 times 3 is 12. And then 12 times 2 is 24. And then you multiply by 1, and it's still 24. So our first example here is write the first three terms of a sequence whose nth term is a sub n is equal to 3 to the n power over n plus 3 factorial, or n plus 3. Our book, my pre-calculus book, is introducing the factorial notation with the introduction of sequences. So that's the first example. Now, we're going to find, let's see, the first three terms. So I want to let n equal 1, and then 2, and then 3 to find the first three terms of the sequence. So a sub 1 is going to be equal to, now if I write a sub 1, I'm letting the n value be, you know, 1. So 3 to the first power over, again, a sub 1 means n equals 1, so 1 plus 3 factorial. That's going to be equal to 3 over, 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 factorial. And then that is going to be equal to 3 over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So we have, as always, or usually, anyway, not always, but as usual, with factorials, you will have some cancellation going on. And we have a 3 on the top of our fraction and a 3 in the denominator. So that will indeed reduce. And you want to do that to keep the numbers as small as possible. So we have 1 over 4 times 2, which is equal to 8. So a sub 1 has a value of 1/8. A sub 2, I was trying to make this all fit, but I think I'm going to have to erase part of this as I go. A sub 2. Well, a sub n is equal to 3 to the n over n plus 3, so a sub 2 is going to be 3 squared over n plus 3, or 2 plus 3, factorial. I'll space this out a little better because I'm never going to get this to fit. I'm doing three parts of this. So 3 squared is 9 over 2 plus 3, which is 5. Factorial, or 9 over 5. And 9 over 5 is equal to 9 over 5 factorial is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just to keep the numbers smaller again as I do this in my head, 9 is equal to 3 times 3, and we have a 3 in the denominator. So this will cancel out, leaving us with just a 3 on the top, and a sub 2 is equal to 3 over 5 times 4 is 20, and then 20 times 2 is equal to 40. So we have our first a sub value, a sub 1 is equal to 1/8. We have a sub 2, which is equal to 3 over 40. And just to make sure that you have it down, as I erase this, why don't you pause it and try and work out a sub 3 really quick. And then I'll do it for you and see if you get the right answer. A sub 3. Okay, a sub 3. 3 to the n, so it would be 3 cubed over 3 plus 3 factorial. That's going to be 3 cubed is going to be 3 times 3 is 9, times 3 is 27, over 3 plus 3, which is 6 factorial, and 6 factorial is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Now, 27 is 3 times 9, or 3 times 3 times 3. So let's see here. We can cancel out the 3 with the 27 and get a 9. And then the 9 has a divisor of 3, but so does the 6. So we can cancel again and say, well, okay, 9 divided by 3 is 3, 6 divided by 3 is 2, and I don't think I can reduce any more. So we have 27's been canceled out. Then we went down to 9, so we have 3 over 2 times 5 is 10, times 4 is 40, times 2 is equal to 80. So a sub 3 is equal to 3 over 80. Let me double check, and yes it is. We're going to get to the next screen, do two more examples of reducing fractions with factorials, and do another example, the last example, dealing with factorials. Next example, 24 factorial over 22 factorial. If you were to put that in your calculator, it's very, very plausible that your calculator will give you an error and just not do the problem at all, or give you a question, well, it might work, depends on the type of calculator, but it's very easy with factorial questions to overload the calculator and have it just simply not give you an answer. So these questions that have factorials that are in, especially the ones that are in fraction form, you want to expand those a little bit by hand, not especially, but all of them. You want to expand those by hand and let, you know, just think about the cancellation before you go and just grab your calculator right away and see if you can't get an answer. So 24 factorial over 22 factorial. Well, factorials are when you, again, start multiplication and count backwards to 1. So 24 factorial is 24 times 23 times 22 times 21, dot, 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 all the way back until you get to 1, right? Factorial. So we'll do the same at the top and the same with the denominator. 22 factorial is 22 times 21, dot, 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 all the way back until you get to the value of 1. So this is 24 factorial divided by 22 factorial. And look what's going to happen. All of these are factors. All of these values are being multiplied together. And when you have a like factor on the top and the bottom of a fraction, they reduce, right? Like 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. So 22 divided by 22 is 1. 21 divided by 21 is 1. And indeed, all of these values starting after 22 are going to cancel with the denominator. And again, we can do this because all of these values are being multiplied together. They're all factors. Well, what are we left with? We're left with 24 times just 23. And 24 times 23, let's get that written correctly, is equal to 552. So, that's how you deal with or evaluate factorials in a fraction. Expand them a little bit, you do the cancellation, and then maybe if you need to, you know, use your calculator at the end to help you figure it out. Like if you put 24 factorial in your calculator and think you're going to get a number, even if it gives you one, it'll be in scientific notation and not be very useful for this kind of question. Not if you want an exact value answer. 2 times n minus 1 factorial over n, or just n factorial. Well, this is, you know, how, this is an algebraic fraction, so all we're left with, or all we can possibly do, is simply reduce the fraction. So we have, let's expand this out like we did our numbers and see what happens. 2, oh, before I continue on with this, a lot of students will want to take this value of 2 and distribute it through the parentheses, because that's what we've always done when there's been a number in front of a set of parentheses. But these parentheses are a grouping symbol for the factorial symbol. So you can't, just like here, we have 2 square root of x. This is not equal to the square root of 2x. We can't just distribute or multiply into that math function without really thinking about what's going on. So we cannot do the same thing with the factorial symbol. Do not put this 2 through the parentheses. We must apply the factorial symbol first, and then if we have anything left, then multiply the 2 in. So we have 2 times n minus 1, and we're counting backwards, but now it's in general form. Think of the definition I just erased. N factorial was n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 times n minus 3 all the way back to the value of 1. That's because, you know, what do you do when you make numbers smaller by value of 1? You subtract 1. So the next number here is going to be what? N minus 1 minus 1 is n minus 2. And indeed, this pattern of counting backwards by 1 is going to continue until you get down to a value of 1. I don't know what the number is I'm starting with, but I'm going to count backwards until I get to 1. And n factorial is n times n minus 1 times n minus 2, again, just subtracting by 1 until I get back to my values of 1. Cancel every common factor from the numerator and denominator, and that's going to be everything from n minus 1 back, and 2 times n minus 1 factorial over n factorial, or 2 times n minus 1 over n is equal to 2 over n. Okay, we got one more example, and it's going to be related to the summation notation, and we're done. Bam, last example. Express the sum using summation notation. Again, we're studying sequences right now in precalculus, and I've already done a video with some of these questions at the end of it, two examples. This one, though, incorporates the factorial notation. So we're going to try and write a summation notation expression. You have a choice of what your lower limit is. You have a choice of what your upper, well, you don't really have a choice of the upper limit, but because the upper limit is going to depend on how you start your summation index, whether you start at 0, 1, 2, 3, or whatever. And then we're going to fill up, you know, an answer. So we can start our k values with anything we like. And I kind of didn't leave myself very much room here. So let's say that k is equal to, now, I'm going to pause a minute and let you try and figure this out, but just in case you would like to check your work with mine, and there's not necessarily just one right answer for this problem, but I'm going to say that when I write my solutions, I'm going to start my k values off here as 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So see if you can find a pattern that will turn a 1 into a 1 and a 1, and at the same time, turn a 2 into a 1 or a 3, or and a 3. A 3 into a 2 and a 5, a 4 into a 6 and a 7, and a 5 into a 24 and a 9. And remember, handle the numerator and the denominator separately as their own sort of like mini questions. So we're looking for an expression that turns a 1 to a 1, 2 into a 1, 3 into a 2, 4 into a 6, and a 5 into 24. And you're looking for another expression that does the same except for the denominators. So go ahead and pause it and try and work that out, because these questions are really the most thought-provoking problems that are in the sections I'm currently teaching, and you do need to struggle with them a little bit to really get those skills down and be able to do this on a quiz. Okay, so we're going to start our lower index value at 1. And you might notice the pattern in the denominator quicker than the numerator, because what's going on in the denominator is we're simply adding by 2. So about 2, my next video actually is going to be about the arithmetic sequence, and an arithmetic sequence is when you're constantly adding by 2. So you might be able to figure out the denominator of this expression by using your knowledge of arithmetic sequences, but if you're following this along with my pre-calc class, you haven't learned that yet. So how do you turn a 1 into a 2, a 1 into a 1, a 2 into a 3 into a 5, a 4 into a 7, or a 5 into a 9? Well, if I double these numbers, 1 times 2 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8, and 5 times 2 is 9. So if I take my k values and I double them all, I get a product that's just 1 bigger than what I have in my denominator. So my denominator is going to be 2k minus 1. And when you think of a pattern down, make sure you check it for at least 3 of the terms, if not more. So 2 times 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1, 2 times 2 is 4, minus 1 is 3, 2 times 3 is 6, minus 1 is 5, 2 times 4 is 8, minus 1 is 7. Okay, it seems like we're working. So these are distracting me down here. Now I need an expression that will work for the top, and I still need to use these same k values because now I have it set for the denominator. Well, this pattern, until this video, may have been brand new to you, but now look. From 1 to 1, we're multiplying by 1. From 1 to 2, we're multiplying by 2. From 2 to 6, we're multiplying by 3. And from 6 to 24, we're multiplying by 4. So we're multiplying through the numerators, and we keep multiplying by one value that's 1 larger. So that's a factorial pattern. I multiply by 1, I multiply by 2, I multiply by 3, I multiply by 4. That's the reverse of the factorial pattern. So something must be going on here that's factorial. Now, 1 factorial is 1, that's good, but 2 factorial is not equal to 1, it's equal to 2. And 3 factorial is equal to 6. And 4 factorial is equal to not 6, but 24. So we're just one step away from the factorial pattern working perfectly. And the problem with why we have the same product value of 1 twice in a row is because 0 factorial is 1, 1 factorial is 1, 2 factorial is 2, 3 factorial is 6, so our numerator is going to be whatever k is, and if we subtract 1, it'll work out, and so our upper limit is going to be 5. And again, just to double check this, put that in the same color. K minus 1 factorial, so K, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 factorial is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 factorial is 1, 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 factorial is 2, 4 factorial minus 1, or 4 minus 1 factorial, that's 3 factorial, and 3 times 2 times 1 is 6. I'm Mr. True, that is my last example. Bam! Go do your homework.